Hey everyone, my name is Brad Miller, and this is the re-record of the Health Huddle from yesterday evening. It was a great call, and I messed up and didn't push the record button correctly. There's been some updates on the computer, so now you have to press it twice. So my apologies, especially because it was a really great call. So that's kind of why I'm jumping on the re-record, because normally when we have a mishap, we just let it go. But this is such a great topic, and I'm going to try my best to recreate the call from yesterday. But again, if they're new, welcome. We do this call every single week. This is where we plant ourselves to learn from others, to get ourselves focused. And just because the good old-fashioned fact is that you surround yourself with the people that lift you up, and you're most like those people that you surround yourself with. So just kind of a quick recap on why yesterday's call was so great. And again, here's just a really good tip for trying to be on live. It is always better live, and you don't have to watch me doing the re-record when someone messes up the record situation. But we had people chime in from where they were, all of the United States. I literally think we covered all 50 states, which was really powerful. People shared a lot in the chat about what's going well in their health. We kind of pose it as like, you might be new, you might have been on your journey for a long time, you might have been here in the past, and then you're here with us again. You may be a veteran in your health journey. Either way, we're starting this year focusing on our health and taking it to the next level. And to really do all that, we thought, I mean, we cover different topics all the time each week, but we're decided to kind of go these next few weeks through the OptaVia guide again. Because here's a little tip from someone who's 8 years on their health journey. It really comes down to the basics that you continue to hone yourself over and over again. It's not any new fad. It's no, you know, this gimmick, that gimmick. It honestly comes down to reawakening and refocusing and re-energizing yourself in new seasons on the basics. That's why we call it the Habits of Health, and this is why this program works so well. That's why it's been there for me. It's why my family's lost over 2,000 pounds combined. It's why I'm here healthier 8 years later with minimal ups and downs in my journey. So if you don't have this, it's fantastic. You can go to optavia.com and download it. It's got great tips. It's got a daily tip. And if you're in our focus group, we've been going through each tip daily every single morning. It's got a great food journal, which is fantastic. If you don't journal, I highly recommend it, or at least for this season, just to kind of get in the full routine of it, which is great. And then, of course, all your lean and green layouts and all of those things, which I didn't mention this yesterday, but man, I just thought it was so cool. I was out and about yesterday, and I started this year on the 5-1 morphing into a 4-2 plan just because I didn't need to lose much weight. I just really wanted that energy of the fat burn. But it made it so easy going into a 4-2. I realized like all you have to do is follow the guidelines for a lean and green. Like, I know that's not like an epiphany, but it just kind of hit me the other day where I'm like, I don't need to think about the stuff like what the lean and green guides you to. It literally gives you a template to practice every single day what a healthy meal is. So it's like, okay, protein, lean protein, a healthy protein, good non-starchy vegetables. That's a no-brainer. Like, you just get programmed to seek that out in the world, and it's really good. So anyways, to the topic tonight, or this morning, it was last night's topic, but last week we covered the topic of awakening habits of healthy weight management. And beyond just focusing on health, in general, weight management is a huge part of it. Many of us started this journey just purely for weight loss, not realizing that we were going to bring in other aspects of it. I know that was me. And we cover a lot of great things that are the basics. You know, Dr. A, our co-founder, helped develop this guide. He's a master in developing habit change and assisting people to better health. So it just covered a lot of the basics, which are the basics that make the difference. Using your smartphone to make alarms to remember to eat, practicing that 2 to 3 hour mark, drinking your water, having a water bottle that you take with you, having backups, because every time we lose that, we don't want to be off of our routine. Connecting with your health coach, it's so key. I know it seems like silly, but making a plan and making a habit of connecting with your health coach, knowing that they're your support and your guide, and mostly your friend, to achieve those things. See here, make sure I don't miss any here. Linking arms, connecting with the community, hashtagging your victories, making meal plans, prepping your fuelings, getting social on social media with the people that support you in your journey. These are all the things that we covered on in the first week of the OptaVia guide, which are, these are huge, and these will help you over time continue towards your healthy weight and success in this area. It might be up and down, which is part of the reason why we are covering tonight week two, which is, oops, let's see here. Where is that? I need to wake up this morning here. But basically, I know it's right here. I just got to grab it. There we go. Connecting mindfulness and awareness to your journey. And I know this might seem kind of, if you're one of the people that are literally on your second week, you're not just re-practicing the second week with us. You're like, wow, I'm just getting down my meal time. What does this mean? And this honestly is huge. This is why Dr. Ray laid it out like this. On your second week, as you start to build on what went well last week, these tips are super handy because it's a time where you're not just doing a diet. You're going to start connecting these things to a long-term journey, habits that you are building, and mindfulness that will honestly kind of start to bleed into other areas of your life. So these are just some of the tips that will kind of that are there, and I'll speak to that, and I'll kind of recap what amazing people share in the chat. I can't even try to recreate all the people that shared in the chat their victories and what this had done for them, or what they wanted to kind of awaken this week, or what they kind of noticed. We actually asked people in the chat, like, did you start to be aware of mindfulness in your journey last week if you were some newer person, or what made a difference for you in mindfulness over time? But day eight and then a few other the ones here are just practicing the mindfulness of connecting what you're doing daily to an overall sense of your health and your being, your life, and a focus on other areas that matter most, because health is not just losing weight. Health is how you treat your body, how you treat your mind, stressors in your life. You know, it's also why we say healthy finances, because finances are a stressor in a lot of people's lives. We want people being mindful and good stewards of their finances. You know, good relationships, good focus, good sleep, good motion, all of those things. So day eight is literally practicing mindfulness and bringing that into attention in your life. It even starts with giving you an idea of, like, taking your time of mindfulness of how you eat your meals. Are you scarfing them, or are you taking time to slowly enjoy them? Because it doesn't say this in here, but that's because of a tip. It takes 10 minutes to realize that you're full. So if you take a slower time to enjoy your meals, you don't need to eat more. You just need to enjoy the ones you have a little bit longer. So taking smaller bites, enjoying them, cut them into small pieces. Day nine is practicing your mindfulness. You'll become more connected and truly what's truly important to you as you begin to see some of these biggest opportunities connect with your health coach and suggest and support during the OptaVia journey. So basically what they're saying here is you might notice other things sticking out as you're really starting to focus and hone in your health. You might start to notice what really is mattering to you most, or things about yourself, or things that you desire, like restful time, or stress in your life, or a relationship you decide to spend more time in, or things that you just like, honestly, that passes by in day-to-day life. Like, is there a hobby, or is there a passion of yours that you have let go that you want to bring back into your life? It also talks about hydration, but again, just bringing mindfulness to that. So last week was remembering to drink your water. This week is, how are you consuming that water? For me, like, I love sparkling water. It's been a huge turning point because I used to not like it at all. Have you added cucumbers or something to infuse your water with? Like in the Northwest, it's really cold right now, so tea is a big bonus. And then it goes on to just talk about some other ones, which is like, make sure I can find them here. There they are. Knowing that you're not alone in the journey, using the hashtag OptaVia, but also connecting with the Facebook groups that are in here. Taking a little bit of extra time to prepare your fuelings or your lean and green, just some extra time blocked out, especially in a world where social media and all this stuff takes extra time in our world, just making time to slow down and enjoy the process. And I know that's been huge for me. And then this one's probably the most timely, progress versus perfection. If you're 13 days in, which is a day 13 tip, you probably had a, oh, I didn't do perfect, especially if you're a new person or if you're recommitting wherever you're at here. It's not about perfection. Perfection's only going to get you to a weight loss goal faster. Progress and focusing on progress is going to get you to optimal health over time. What I always share with people that are on this journey with me that I've seen and that are come along with me, so I share with them, you know, if I didn't do perfect on my second month, that doesn't change where I'm at 8 years later. because it's not about how perfect I am. Push yourself to go further. Push yourself to be your best. Don't make excuses, but don't beat yourself up. It literally is about progress and not perfection. So I think that one's a huge one in mindfulness and just connecting that to yourself. I'm sure, again, this is some little different variation of what we talked about last night, but I'm sure in the last week or since the new year or wherever you're at, or if you've been on the journey many years, you probably had a day that just sucked and you didn't feel good. Maybe you wanted to just go to bed, or maybe that hunger crept up because you had such a bad day. When we're stressed, we tend to want junk food. It's part of one of the reactions or different habits that we built. Maybe you gave into it. Maybe it wasn't perfect. Maybe it was just a bad day. But if you just focus on getting over that and taking the next step, or no matter what you did, the next day is the next day. Progress, not perfection, is what makes the deal. And planting yourself in this community and planting yourself in these changes and the mindfulness is what makes the difference. So that's why I think it's key that Dr. Ray brought that up. He honestly, guys, we don't get to brag on him enough. And hopefully you guys get to see him or hear him talk or reading The Habits of Health. He's an amazing man who left a career in medicine, a very prestigious career. Like, literally people thought he was crazy when he left, because he desires to help people make the changes in health that you see all around you. It's pretty amazing. So I hope for all of you that you get a chance to meet him someday. Even if you're brand new and you guys don't even know who I'm talking about, he's the guy on the book that you guys got in Dr. A's Habits of Health. So that is the tip for this week. I hope it guides you. Dawn and Lori came on about just how big mindfulness was there in Hawaii. And I just thought it was really cool because they both have lost, you know, close to 40 pounds and are vibrant in their health, not only just their bodies, but and physically and more active, but like they're healthy in their life. And it was just really cool to just get to see them in Hawaii. I think we've all had that issue where we're like, oh, I'm not really confident in a bathing suit. They're confident in a bathing suit. They don't have that holding them back. There's no weight. Literally, I mean, there's no weight on their shoulders of needing to worry about that. And that is a lot of freedom that comes along with this journey. Plus just getting to learn to like yourself a little bit more, just the way you are, and knowing that everyone is just on this roller coaster ride called life. But I just thought it was really cool. They shared a lot about what mindfulness has meant for their journey. And then I asked them at the end, what was the first thing they kind of caught on to as far as mindfulness? And I thought it was amazing because both of them had different answers. Dawn's was, she started to actually learn about her body, like why she was tired or why she was hurting or why she was hungry or why she was stressed or where that feeling came from, because she never paid attention to her body, even as a registered nurse, you know, and knowing everything she knows about the body. This journey not only helped her get healthier and feel better, that's a given, it helped her be mindful of what her body was telling her. And I know that was huge for me. Lori's was great too, because her first connection with mindfulness in her journey was recognizing that she would probably start doubting herself, and the ability of the support and the structure and just how easy things were, that she could keep going on plan. Like, basically that she didn't give in to those things that go on in our head. And I just thought those were two great examples, because I think we all have that going on at different levels. And so, you know, mine was, I'll say copy paste on all of that. And also just basically being like, wow, I'm really aware of how I'm eating, what I'm eating, what's going on around me. I think that was the big epiphany for me personally. I noticed that, like, I remember filling out a form in the military years ago, and it said, do you eat fast food 2 times a week or more? And it was like a bad answer to say yes. And I remember being like, well, that's what everyone does. Like, why is that a problem? And like, these forms, yeah, that's, you know, that's, I was just laughing at it. And then really just stop and think, like, learning all these things, that we don't have a society that is set up to serve us and what's actually well for our health. And realizing that what I thought I had learned about how I should live and health and all of those things, because of what I watched going on around me, was not right. So that was another huge mindfulness for me. And then realizing that I've shifted that slowly but surely over time. Like, I still have my hiccups, but I have this thing to grab onto to make it each week better, and this community support me. So those were the takeaways. They were huge. My encouragement to everyone this week on the call was to start to look for those mindfulness spots in your journey. Follow along with the guide. If you don't have it, print it out or check it out, or make sure you go reference it from the one you got originally. Start to think about the ones that you want to be more mindful of, and start to notice the ones where you're realizing mindfulness in your life. And then I actually had another challenge to everyone on here. Actually, I had three by the end of it. Is this is a part of mindfulness, realizing that there are people that want better health in our life. And believe it or not, wherever you're at on this journey, you're an inspiration to somebody. So my challenge is to live it a little bit more out loud, share it on Facebook about how you're getting healthier, or encourage someone around you today, and just in the name of being healthier and being better and stepping up, let people know, because what you don't realize is that people are watching your changes, and your changes are pretty phenomenal. People wish for it. There's a reason why more than 50% of Americans make a goal, a New Year's resolution, to do something like we're all doing here. So just go bring that positivity into the world and bring that mindfulness into the fact that there are people wanting that same thing, and you might be able to lift them up. My last tip or challenge or encouragement this week was, wherever you're at, practice mindfulness. Realize it's a journey. It's not about progress, not perfection. But as this community that steps you up and encourages you to be your best, step up your game this week. Do something above and beyond. Push yourself. You are capable more than anything that you think that is possible. So whether you think you can, or you're having a great week or a bad week or anything in between, know that you can do anything. So take some extra moments this week. Step up your game. And we want to encourage you to be your best. So have a great week. And I can't wait to hear next week what you are mindful of in your journey and how it affected you and what these things that are turning in your health journey are created in your life. So have a great week, everybody. Catch the live, because this was nowhere near as cool as the recording or the live call was. So hopefully the tips are helpful. Look forward to celebrating these all with you next week. Have a good night.